Hello, and thanks for joining me for the Bismarck Weather Education Center's video on El Nino in North Dakota. If you like, you can read an official definition of El Nino. However, remember these key things. It is an interaction between the ocean and atmosphere, caused by warmer than normal water in the east-central equatorial Pacific. For more on this process and the greater El Nino Southern Oscillation, check out our video on ENSO on the Bismarck Weather Education Center's YouTube page. Yada yada yada. What does El Nino mean for us in North Dakota? More blizzards? More heat? Flooding? Well, let's take a look at what El Nino means for a North Dakota winter. During a normal or non-El Nino winter, the polar jet stream's typical location is over the northern and central U.S. During El Nino winter, the average location of the polar jet shifts north into Canada. This means that conditions across North Dakota and much of the northern U.S. and western Canada are warmer than normal. So how much warmer? Only about 2 degrees warmer than normal when averaged over all of winter. We know, 2 degrees is not all that exciting, but it is better than you think. Remember the typical polar jet stream location during an El Nino? This is only the average location over winter. The polar jet is constantly moving north and south and changing shape, whether it is an El Nino year or not. However, during an El Nino winter, the polar jet dives south into the northern and central United States less often. So it does not mean a degree or two warmer each day, but instead this means fewer cold air outbreaks over North Dakota, meaning fewer days where the temperatures are well below zero. Now for the other factor in a North Dakota winter, snowfall. Pretty simple, El Nino results in less snow for North Dakota. How much less? That's tricky. For example, the El Nino that spanned the winter and spring of 1968 and 69 resulted in only slightly less snow than normal, while an El Nino of similar intensity that spanned the winter and spring of 1997 and 98 resulted in far less snow than normal, only half as much as normal in some locations. This equates to a difference of about 20 inches of snow between the two snowfall seasons, which makes forecasting how much less very difficult. However, an average of all El Nino events suggests that North Dakota will see about 3 to 6 inches less snow for the winter and spring. With that said, remember that snow across the state from season to season is highly variable, whether it is an El Nino year or not. So there is one caveat to all this. El Nino has three different severities: weak, moderate, and strong. The stronger the El Nino that develops, the more likely North Dakota is to see above normal temperatures, and less snow than normal. Also, a moderate or strong El Nino can lead to more enhanced effects, while a weak El Nino can barely noticeable. So you probably noticed that we did not go over El Nino's effects on summer or fall. The reason for that is because El Nino does not play a big role in weather patterns over North Dakota during the summer or fall. El Nino's main influence is felt over the winter months and even into spring. Thanks for listening, and I hope this video taught you a little more about El Nino in North Dakota. For more on El Nino, you can check out NOAA's official El Nino homepage. And for more on weather education and what we do here at the Bismarck National Weather Service office, stay tuned to our homepage and social media sites for more videos from the Bismarck Weather Education Center.